You have to win the game. You have to. You don't want to win the game? Too bad. You gotta. Or you could watch me win the game. That's an option as well. Hi, my name's Duke. Happy Saturday. I'm streaming on YouTube for the first time, so I have no idea if this is even working. Fortunately, CPC Gamer is in the chat room to help me troubleshoot things. This is a DOS-style exploration platformer by Pirate Hearts. This game is free. You can get it on Steam. And I like this game quite a bit. I like exploration platformers, and this is a pretty dang good one. So let's jump in and start a new game. I have the chat up in the top right-hand corner of the screen. Perhaps you can see it. I haven't decided if I want to keep this or not. I think it's pretty unobtrusive up there. I set this up this way because there's no way for me to do the chat captions or the chaptions that I do when I stream on Twitch because the YouTube chat does not have timestamps. So if I want to include the chat in the video, this is pretty much the only way for me to do it. And Jacob Xanth says I'm live now. Hey, what's up, Jacob? CPC Gamer says he sees me. Okay, awesome. Looks good. If you guys have an opinion about keeping the chat room here, let me know. That goes to anyone watching the video down the line. I thought, you know, as long as I'm experimenting, I'd try this out. There are downsides to this, but hopefully the pluses of streaming on YouTube as opposed to Twitch will outweigh the minuses. So let's stop yammering and jump in here. There are two campaigns, original and extra spicy. I will be doing both. I don't know if I'll be doing both in this broadcast, but I will eventually be showing off both on stream, and I will try to 100% both campaigns. I like this screen because it makes me think that there will be more campaigns down the line. That's probably not going to be the case, but, you know, it's nice to dream. I will be doing original. There are two modifiers here that make it more difficult. I won't be choosing either of those. So similar to most DOS games of the era, there's not going to be much music in this game, and I thought about playing some music in the background, but I decided against it because it goes against the spirit of this kind of game. These old DOS-style games always had a real kind of lonely feel to them because of the lack of music, and I wanted to keep that. Hello Kutef in the chat. Jacob remembers really liking the CRT framing for this game. Well, I have some bad news. I'm not going to be using the CRT mode. I just wanted to kind of show it off. This is the default appearance of the game. And I'm not going to be playing the whole game like this. It is a really cool CRT filter. It's really well done. But I don't like playing an entire game in this mode. I feel it's kind of distracting. And I want the full widescreen experience. So I'm going to pop into the options here. Also, the default color scheme is CGA, which is, I guess it's four colors if you count black and white. We have kind of cyan and magenta here. I don't remember if there are more colors later in the game. But I don't really have a lot of nostalgia for this style of graphics, so I'm going to go into the options and turn on EGA graphics, which is 16 colors. You can turn off the monitor border, which makes the CRT filter a little better. It's a little less distracting this way. Yeah, look at that. Check out all those colors. It's a cool filter, but yeah, like I said, I would rather have it off if I'm going to be actually playing the game. So CRT simulation off. Okay. There we go. Check out that aspect ratio. Alright, so we have one instruction here. Go. And I'm not sure what this number 8 refers to. Perhaps we will find out later. It's a one-button game. It's just jump. You touch these. This is the checkpoint. Kind of similar to I Want to Be the Guy style games. Not nearly as difficult, of course, although the second campaign, the extra spicy campaign, will get a little more challenging as I go. Well, it told me to die, and I did, and it told me to respawn, and I did. There's a bag of money up there, which there's no way for me to get that yet, but I imagine I will be able to get it sometime down the line. Kind of interesting that it does the VVV, VVV style title of each room down at the bottom of the screen. That wasn't really something you saw in a lot of DOS games in my experience. And we got our first money back. We are at 2%. Yeah, it seems like that was more of a Commodore 64 style thing, but they included it in this game, which is pretty cool. So we have two options. We can go down or we can go to the danger zone. So there's a bag of money down there, and if I was playing in a mode where the number of lives I have actually matters, then I would not get that yet, because there's no way to get this at the current, in our current power level without dying. There's no way to jump back up there. But when you respawn, any money you grab stays in your inventory. So I don't have to worry about the danger zone just yet. Path will I take? Well, you read from left to right, so logically I want to start going left. We have our first kind of tricky jump here. Grab that cash. Yeah, I like the look of this style of graphics much more than the cyan and magenta style. This is closer to the style of DOS games that I actually played, which I didn't play many in this style, but I have played a few. The one that sticks out in my mind the most is probably WizOrb, or not WizOrb. WizOrb is the it's the Arkanoid style game that I streamed. What's the name of that game? I guess it was WizBall. Which was a weird game where you control this bouncing ball with a really odd control scheme. But I remember it looking somewhat like this. Alright, where the heck am I going? We will be able to do things besides just jump later on, but for now the only ability that we have is to jump. Yeah, WizBall, thanks CPC Gamer. Shouldn't take me too long to 100% this game, since I have done it in the past, in the not too distant past. It was sort of recent. No relation to you have to burn the rope. Nope, Levant, no relation to that game. Which, when I first heard of this game, I kind of gave it a pass because I thought it was going to be a joke game. Like, you have to burn the rope is kind of a joke game that only takes, I don't know, 2 minutes at most to beat. But this is a pretty full, fleshed out game. And there's a sequel to this game called Super Win the Game, which I will also be playing eventually, which is that one's not free. I think it's about $8 on Steam, and it's done in a very NES style as opposed to a DOS style, but that game's really cool as well. Oh god, and we have our first quote-unquote boss, the Hollow King. Well, we're gonna have to go right from here, which if I want to go right, I shouldn't have destroyed that platform. Hey, we have our first ability. Activates blue ghost blocks. Hey, we can get across this bridge now. Awesome. Alright, let's go back to the lair of the Hollow King and see what's to the left there. Yeah, the music in this game is very reminiscent of the DOS style, which is kind of short bursts of music. Like, in this era of PC gaming, music that plays the entire time in the background, like console style, was pretty uncommon. Like you had DOS, or you had, I guess at the time, you had like IBM clones, which were running DOS, and you had the Apple II, and you had like the ZX Spectrum also had kind of similar, very sparse music throughout. And the Commodore 64 was really the big PC of the time that had good enough music hardware to play music the entire time in the background. Oops. I probably shouldn't have jumped right into that bullet. Like there were some exceptions. Like you had Moon Patrol on the Apple II, which was one of the I think that's the only game I've ever played on the Apple that had music playing constantly in the background. And it wasn't very good music either. That was kind of the other feature of the Apple II. Okay, well, we can't get past this cave-in. All right, this should be pretty doable. Wait, can I jump up there yet? No, I can't. Okay. Spoiler alert. You will eventually get abilities that improve your jump height. Shocking, I know. Obvious movie quote. I'm tired of all these MFing snakes on those MFing bars. Okay. Obvious movie quote out of the way. Aw, man. I can't get that money back now because I activated the blue ghost blocks. Yeah, exactly, CPC. The option for the 8-bit consoles was music or sound effects, but not both. And Moon Patrol tried to do both, but it did it not very well. Oh, well, I guess I'm gonna have to just grab that money bag and then die. But since I'm playing on the normal difficulty, that's not a big deal. I just respawn a little bit backwards. Oh, don't mind if I do. See, we're already at 20%. Time is just flying by. So the money bags is not how you win the game, it's just sort of a bonus objective. How you win the game is, well, I guess you'll see. There's exactly one puzzle you have to solve in this game, and it's not a very tricky one. This is a really difficult jump. Okay. Dang it. I thought I respawned back up there. What popularized the name for each green thing? I know other stuff has it. I believe the game that made that popular was Jet Set Willy on the Commodore 64. There might have been games that did that before Jet Set Willy, but that's the one. That's the one that inspired VVVVVV. I know that much. I think the creator of that game has said as much. All right, awesome. You definitely shouldn't go left. Well, since when have I? Oh, I guess it was right. I shouldn't have gone left. Well, lesson learned. Wait a sec. I need to go up and get that money bag before I go this way anyway. I shouldn't have hit that bell. By the way, let me know if the sound balance and everything is good or not. I tried to set it up before the stream, but I never know how stuff is actually going to sound on the stream itself. All right, so I needed to go left so I can go back up here. Awesome. Trinket get. Yeah, and getting all the money bags doesn't even really affect the story or anything. Like, it affected the story in VVVVVV, but it is literally just an achievement in this game, essentially. Alright, I will not go left this time. I will take the screen's advice. Jet Set Willy and Manic Miner. Some versions of Monty on the Run also did that. Oh, I did not know that about Monty on the Run. Dang it. I never played any of those games, by the way. That's just secondhand knowledge. That was more of a European set of games. The Commodore 64 did have a presence in the US, but it wasn't nearly as big as its presence in Europe. Tower of Sorrows. Is this okay, so yeah, this is an infinite loop. So I need to, there we go. Get that, then head to the right. We'll come back for that. Functional speleology? I don't know how that letter is pronounced. I know that in British English, encyclopedia, the second E is that sort of weird AE combined letter, so I guess it's pronounced E. I don't know what speleology is. Fungal forest. So just for comparison's sake, let's jump in and disable the EGA graphics real quick. Oops. Off. Back. Yes. Yeah, they're just the same kind of cyan colors, everything else, which it kind of removes some of the atmosphere of the game, I think. Like, with EGA graphics, you have this cool kind of, you know, I mean, it's a color you haven't seen before in this game up to this point. So it's like, oh, I'm definitely in a new area now because it's a new color. But without the EGA graphics, it's just kind of the same thing as everything else. So it's up to personal preference, I guess. I mean, if you play games in that EGA style, then it's probably striking a nostalgia chord with you. But like I said, I did not really play any games in that style. This jump looks sort of doable, but I guess it doesn't. Nope, have to come back. Nope, cannot get up there yet. Well, that looks like a hole I should be able to go down, but I guess it isn't. Oh, by the way, if you hit the down button, he does kind of this cool headbang thing. Like, yeah, don't stop the music. Which, it's even better when you play in YOLO mode, because he's wearing sunglasses, and he really looks like a rocker. Oh, man. Well, can you stand on these Metroids? I didn't think so. Okay. Danger down here? Well, danger's my middle name. Nope. Not that kind of danger. What is the magic symbol? That is a clue. We'll have to remember that clue later for when we solve the puzzle in this game. Nope. Don't get snippy with me. I get it, because it's a crab. Yeah, that's pretty good. Oh, crap. Boss number two. Apparently this is a dire crab. Hey, there we go. Red ghost blocks are activated. So we can get up here. Nice. And does that mean we can fall down here now? No, not yet. Okay, good to know. However, we can get past these Metroids. I only call them Metroids because they have those three red dots in the middle of them, which makes them look Metroid-like. Hey, what's up, Privacy? Thanks for hanging out. Prawn shot first. I get it. It's like a reference to that movie, Spaceballs. Man, Spaceballs is so good. Can't believe they're making a new Spaceballs. I can't wait. I hope Mel Brooks is still young enough to play Yogurt again. Well. Won't be able to get that money back. You have to be inspired by Metroids. Yeah, that's what I figure. Circular logic. So I imagine if I go left here, if I'll come out the right side of the screen. Yeah. Alright, well, let's go down then. Oh, well. I guess I should have listened to the danger sign with the arrow pointing down and to the left. Dang it. Oh, that one only gave me 1% instead of 2%. I wonder what dictates how many percentage points a money bag is worth. Crap. Spaceball's Battlefront looks pretty good, yeah. Right, what's to the right? Oh, takes me back there. Okay. Oh, thanks for the heads up, game. I mean, I should have known that because right is the easy path, so obviously there's not going to be anything good in that direction. It never rewards you for taking the easy path. Dang! The color dictates the percent. Oh yeah, that's possible. Of course, in CGA mode, they're all going to be either magenta or cyan. I haven't paid attention to how many different colors the money bags can be in EGA mode. So the other two difficulty modes are YOLO mode, which is one life permadeath, which I will probably never do. And there's also cat mode, where you play as a cat. And the only real difference in cat mode is that you have 9 lives to finish the game. Which, I could probably do that. I've done some pretty difficult things in games before. Not as difficult as beating it in one life, but I could probably do cat mode. So there's not even anything over here. I went through all that for nothing. Wait. Oh yeah, I can't get that one yet. Is there anything else in this direction? No, I guess not. Okay, well, let's see what some of my other options are. Yeah, seems like there has to be something for me to do over here. Try this one more time. Try not dying one more time. I mean, it's not a very difficult bullet pattern, but you do have to be a little patient. Okay, I guess there's nothing over here. Okay, well, let's go back. See what else I can find. I have played this game sort of recently. It was a couple months ago, so a lot of stuff is still fresh in my mind, but I don't remember the exact path. The exact sequence of events. So this just drops me into water, right? Yeah. Interesting. Okay. Well, let's try going up. Oh yeah, I can get up there now that I unlock the red blocks. Okay. So I guess I have to do this before I do. Oh wait, no, I still can't get to that mushroom. Can I get up there from the left? It looks like I can. I just have to get up here and then jump across. Don't mind if I do. So that one was yellow. I didn't notice what it was before I picked it up, though. But now it's 38. Is this the magic symbol? Don't know what that is. It looks sort of like an ichthys? The Jesus fish? I do not think that's the magic symbol. Doesn't seem like a game that would have a lot of Christian imagery in it. It must be a red herring. Get it? Because it's red and it looks like a fish. And it's also there to throw me off. Pretty clever game. Hi, money. So it's 39, pick up a yellow one, and it's 40. So it looks like the yellow ones are worth one, if Jacob Zant's theory is correct. Can't jump up that high. Interesting. Can I jump there? No? Well, what are some of my other options? Have I been up this way? Yeah, that just leads me to the red herring. Some bags have dollars and some bags have cents. Oh, yeah, that would make sense. I like how this game sort of hints at a greater mythology. Like, you have characters that the game doesn't really tell you anything about. Like the Hollow King. In the sequel, it sort of expands on some of that mythology. Which is kind of cool. Okay. Well, now that I have the blue blocks, I can probably do this. I can probably hit the spikes or the bat repeatedly and die. See, the bat changes its position when you scroll screens, which makes timing the actual jump more difficult. In CGA mode, they only have two colors of money bags, so each is worth a different value. Oh, okay. Yeah, I haven't noticed how many different colors are available here. Oh, it's this again. Okay. Oh, here's a place I haven't been. I wonder where this goes. Well, before I find out, let's see where this goes. Hey, it's the Snakes on the Plane level. I've been there before. Now I'm in a deep underground passage. See, it told me not to be hasty. But I was hasty anyway. The controls in this game are actually pretty good. I'm just messing up this jump repeatedly because I suck. Alright, adventure time. Infinity is not the magic symbol. Okay, good to know. We have safety to the left. Do we really need another reference to Portal? I mean, come on, it's 2015. Of course, I don't know when this game came out. I know it was several years after Portal, though. Hi, spider. More scared of me than I am of it. Oh, crap. It's the green man. Run! Forgotten tunnels. Well, definitely no way to do this. So that one didn't give me any percentage points. Interesting. Arbitrarium. Is this it? I don't know what that symbol is. Looks sort of like a three, but it's pointy, and it has little things next to it. Can't do anything here yet.
Ha!
Interesting pattern for these platforms. Right, well, as usual, the easy path was fruitless, so I must take the difficult path. The relatively difficult path. Spring heel boots. Heck yeah, we have a double jump. Now it's a freaking game. I like the slightly different sound effect for the second jump. Come on. Okay. So before I exit this area, I just need to head down here now that I have a double jump. I can get this money bag. I guess the percentage also goes up, like, when you explore new screens and get power-ups and stuff. Because it's going up without picking up the money bags every now and then. Alright, is there anything else down here? Oh yeah, I need to... Man, even my double jump can't get me up there. There must be another power-up. Well, now what? Have to do some crazy stuff now. I don't think I can actually get up this way. I just think that's a different way to get down here. Like, I need to go back the way I came now. Yeah, imagine me trying to do this with one life. Just triple checking. Yep, still can't get that. So I'm gonna have to come back to the Forgotten Tunnels at some point. Okay, that way leads me back to the spider. Is there anything over here? That's also a spider. But there's a second spider. Be seeing ya. I get that reference. Yeah, me too, CPC Gamer. Referencing the screen I was just on. Alright, so, it's back to greenmangaming.com we go. See if we can get a good discount on this screen. You know, on Green Man Gaming, you can actually pre-order the next game from this developer for negative money. You pre-order it, and they'll give you $5. It's a pretty good deal. Game is hard enough, I really don't want to do it on one life. Yeah, me either. Like, even doing it on 9 lives would be kind of a stretch. Yeah, I'll never be that good either, CPC Gamer. Not at this game, anyway. I mean, I have done 1 life runs. I mean, obviously, like, Spelunky is kind of a different case, because that game's always 1 life mode. Well, let's see, I can get over here now. Does that do anything for me? No? Suppose not. Money bag up there to the left. See how I get up there. Wings of V, or Wings of VI, or Wings of Six. I don't actually know how that's pronounced. I've heard of the game. I heard it was kind of neat. Never played it, though. I assume it's Wings of V. Like, even the text editor, VI, I have no idea how that's pronounced either. Alright. Well, now that I have the double jump, there's probably more I can do. Not in this area, but when I go down and further to the left. I assume it's pronounced V, yeah. Hi, Hollow King. Still firing away, I see. One thing I'm trying to get over is my anxiety of not having stuff to say. Because really, there's not a whole lot to say about this game. It's kind of a simple, straightforward platformer. And for some reason, I get really anxious whenever there's any footage just of me playing the game and not talking. Like, I try to force myself to talk just constantly when I do these. And I know that's not always practical. And it's not always entertaining. Sometimes it's entertaining to just watch someone play a game and listen to him or her talk when he or she has something to say. And I need to keep that in mind. And not just constantly try to fill dead air with my yammering. Oh, yeah, okay. I can get that money back now. Cha-ching. I think all the money bags have a cent symbol on them, but when you pick them up, it makes the dollar symbol. So, you're turning cents into dollars. You gotta pick up money to make money. And get past this cave-in from both sides now. Oh, it's this area again. Lame. Did the audio separately and ended up cutting out a lot of it. Felt like it worked better with some silence. Yeah, that's how I feel. Like, when I'm watching a game, if it's a game I'm interested in, the person doing the commentary definitely doesn't need to be always talking to keep it entertaining. Just, I'm always worried that stuff isn't entertaining to people, but my new outlook is that if it's not entertaining to someone, then they just won't watch. And if they don't watch, it's not a big deal. Also, hi, Galen. Thanks for hanging out. Like, I have real issues with, like, rejection and stuff. You know, if I can get deep for a second here. So, like, my tendency is, oh no, no one wants to watch me play a game. Obviously, it's... obviously, it's my fault. I'm so blah blah blah. But, you know, I need to get over that and just kind of enjoy playing a game and talking when I have something to say. Oh, come on! Yeah, one life mode, imagine that. Also, with that outlook, I can stream a lot more often than I normally do. Because usually I think about streaming and I'm like, oh god, I don't even know what I'll say about such and such. But if I just don't worry about it, just talk when I have something to say, then it'll all work out. Mimetic humor, quips, and references. I've stopped trying to be light and I'm having more fun. Yeah, exactly. And I feel like, I don't know, when people don't try so hard, it makes it feel more I don't know, genuine, legitimate. Which makes for a more pleasant viewing experience, I think. Of course, not everyone agrees with me, and that'll be fine too. Oh, this is that big puddle of water I can't get past. Interesting. You chat to me about junk and the talk comes from that. Yeah, exactly. I mean, I wasn't even sure if anyone would come to the stream because A, I didn't give any prior notice, and B, I'm streaming at a time I don't normally stream. But I thought, you know, what the heck? Worth a shot, even if no one shows up, I will play the game and have fun, and if someone wants to watch me have fun later on, then cool. Alright, so now that I have the double jump, there's probably somewhere I can get to in the fungal forest I wasn't able to before. And by probably, I mean definitely. Like, when I first started LPing, I definitely tried to be humorous and entertaining, and I mean, some people are naturally funny. No, I'm not, but, you know, I'm naturally me, and, you know, I offer my own take on things, I offer my own perspective, and some people are into that, which is awesome. I'm very thankful for anyone who is. Here we go. Oh man, there's like a goat skull or something here. Oh, the goat skull kills you. I thought it was just like a sign, a warning, which I guess it is a warning since it kills you. Interesting. Install the YouTube gaming app for the notifications. I get the notifications just with the normal YouTube app on my Android device. I didn't even know there was a separate gaming app. Does it do anything else? Hollow King transformed. Oh, so it's a Hollow King, but now he's like super pissed. This is a difficult pattern. Turn into a bullet hell all of a sudden. I tried to see if jumping through the bullets was a valid strategy, and it was not. I mean, if I did it just right, maybe. It's a Hollow King, but now he faces left. Also, he has something going on with his face there. He looks like he's doing something kind of obscene, to be honest. I won't say what it looks like he's doing, but it is not appropriate for a family-friendly stream. You can watch streams from it and broadcast to Chromecast. Oh, cool. I think you can watch streams just with the normal YouTube app. I don't know if it does Chromecast, though. Because Giant Bomb started doing their streams, well, their public streams, on YouTube and Twitch simultaneously. And I've been checking them out on YouTube on, well, when I didn't have a computer, I would sometimes check it out on the app, and it seemed to work okay. Oh, for crying out loud. There we go. See? My jumping strategy paid off. Cling to walls and leap off. It is 100% Super Meat Boy now, only with better controls. Alright, I need to hit a bell on this side so I don't have to go past the Hollow King every time. There we go. So how do I do this again? I need to... Oh, I remember. I have to break this platform quickly. It is Super Meat Boy in the sense of more difficult platforming, though. It also displays your subscriptions that are gaming-related. Well, all of my subscriptions are gaming-related. Well, except for Ashen's, I guess. He does some gaming stuff, but he also does a lot of just weird crap reviews. We're just... Okay, good. Takes me back here. So I need to go up this way. cannot get up there. Okay. What is this? Oh, it looks like that symbol, but it looks more like a 3 this time. Instead of kind of a pointy 3. Oh, cool. I'll have to download that app and check it out. My Android device is kind of a piece of crap, though. So I don't really use it for that stuff very often. When I have a computer, anyway. Oh, I guess I should have kept going this way. Look at that, first try. Well, first try after all of those failed tries from the last time. Okay, it's a different kind of collectible. It's a pirate heart. Alright, see you later, Private Steve. Thanks for hanging out. Boy. I wish there was music for me to headbang to. Okay. I've been here, but now I can actually get up here. But before I do that, let's try... this direction. An even 0x80. That's some sort of hexadecimal thing. I don't know what that is referring to. I'm sure it's a reference to something. I don't think I actually need to do this, since I already got what was down there, but it's fun to try anyway. Oops. Well, now I need to kill myself just to get back up there. Or I could take the long way around, but screw that. Yeah, there we go. Nice. No reason to do that, other than... showing off. Alright, I just want to double check and make sure I didn't miss any collectibles. Oops, ran out of jumps. Alright, so I got the thing up there. Okay, I'm pretty sure I'm done up here. I don't think there's anything else down here I have to get. Oops. Man, doing this with one life would just be... I mean, you would have to be intimately familiar with this game. Know exactly how to make every jump perfectly. You would just have to put in a ton of time, a ton of practice. Which, you know, I can respect people who can put a ton of time into one game and learn it really well. Like speedrunners and stuff, I think that's awesome. But for me personally, I prefer using my time to play a bunch of different kinds of games. That's just me, though. I mean, for some people, they only play one game. Oh, God. Like, I made that jump, but then I immediately died. Like, they would only play Minecraft, or they would only play League of Legends, or they would only play an MMO. Which I think that's cool. It's not how my brain operates. Aw, man, so close. Aw, man, so close again. Ah, I only get really obsessive like that about MMOs. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's the reason I avoid those kinds of games. Just because I am a person who likes to play all kinds of different stuff. Like, I mean, I just finished playing a racing game, and now I'm playing a retro platformer. And I'd really like to start streaming, like, RPGs and stuff, too. Yeah, same CPC gamer. Like, before I started streaming again, before my computer died, I went through, like, a really hardcore Metroidvania exploration platformer kind of phase, which was when I played this game for the first time. I played a bunch of games during that phase that I will probably end up streaming. Hey, secret cat level. Awesome. We have a cat here. See? Says right there on the sign. Cat. And we also have a cat over here. And up here we have... what? Hmm. Tricky jump. Maybe I have to wall jump to get over there. Yeah, there we go. Bye, cats. Like, if I play something else, I'm missing out on a chance to play with friends. Yeah, that's one reason I don't play a ton of multiplayer games. Because I don't want to... like, if I start playing a game with people, and I'm really into it for a while, then that's pretty awesome. But then, if I lose interest in that genre, when I start doing something else, then I'm letting those people down. That happened with Borderlands, the pre-sequel. I was playing that with Moors and Just Drop and another one of our friends, and we put a few hours into it, and I just kind of totally lost steam. I'm playing that game again now that I have a better computer, and I'm having fun with it, going through it solo. But I feel bad. I let down my friends. That's why the kind of games I play socially are like, I like to play board games with people, you know, something that takes, you know, 30 minutes to an hour to enjoy, card games, and then you play it and you're done. And you can move on to something else, or you can play that game again. That's the kind of stuff I like. Like, I like, the games I like to play online with people are like Board Game Online, something that takes a short amount of time that you can hang out and have fun, and then you're done. Or like the Cards Against Humanity clone. I've been playing that online with some people. Now, I have my issues with Cards Against Humanity, but I think if you play that game with the right people, it can be pretty fun. But yeah, that's the kind of stuff I'm into. I'm worried about playing games that are multiplayer. If they aren't good, I don't have fun. If I'm not good, they aren't enjoying it. Yeah, you kind of have to strike the right balance. Another one of my issues with multiplayer games is if I play games with people who have experience with the game and I have no experience, then I feel like, or I'm worried that I'll feel like they're just kind of leading me through the game and just telling me what to do, and I'm not going to have any fun with it that way. So yeah, it's a tricky thing. Drink some water here. Alright, it's getting pretty stuffy in here, so I'm going to turn the fan on, and let me know if this is unbearably obnoxious, having the fan pointing at me. It's not really pointed at the mic, but I'm worried it'll cause unwanted noise, so let me know if this is horrible, and I'll turn it off again. Alright, the fan's pointed at me. Let me know how this sounds. It's one of the reasons I didn't stream much during the summer, was because I had the fan pointed at me pretty much all the time, and I was worried the sound would be obnoxious in the video, or I would just be extremely uncomfortable while I was streaming. Oh, that's cool, Galen. Yeah, I've watched people play Payday some. Looks interesting. Wait, how do we? Oh, how do I get up there? I say as I wall jump. You can't hear the fan at all? Really? That's awesome. I guess I was worried for nothing. Of course, it's not pointed exactly at me. It's kind of angled away, but it's enough that I have a good breeze going. The cats don't know the magic word. Oh, that's a shame. Oh, hey, it's here, this place again. See, this is how you're supposed to get that money back. You're supposed to grab it, avoid the bat, and once you have the double jump and the wall jump, you can get out alive. You can hear it in the background faintly. Okay, well, hopefully it's not too annoying. Alright, I'm gonna have to go back to the underground area that I teleported to. Because there's a money bag you could only get with the wall jump. And I didn't have the wall jump yet. Exit strategy. So, if you drop down here. Hey, it's the beginning of the game again. And this way actually leads to the end of the game, which I'm not quite ready to do yet. There's the money bag here at the beginning. And then there's the money bag down in the underground area. And I don't know if I'm missing any other money bags. I'm going to have to go towards the end game and see what my percentage looks like. Hopefully it's close to 100% by the time I get to the end. So I need to go back to where that teleporter was. Which is somewhere. How did you miss the It's a Snake gag? Yeah, that's a reference I can get behind. Because you don't really hear many references to Badger, Badger, Badger anymore. Like, you heard them a lot for a couple years in the mid-2000s. But then everyone kind of forgot about it. Portal, I feel like you still hear references to Portal way too often. I played a game recently called Unepic, which is a 2D side-scrolling platformer RPG, and I really like that game mechanically. It's a really cool game. I will probably stream it eventually, but the writing in that game is just awful. Like, it has the same issue with overdone, outplayed internet references. But, you know, it just turns it up to 11, and it's just the most obnoxious thing I've ever played. It's like nothing but internet references and middle school grade dick jokes. Like, that's it. That's all of the writing in that game. And it's a shame, because I really enjoyed how the game plays. Hey, what's up, Vice Commando? Good to see you. I feel like, by streaming on YouTube, I'm seeing people, or I have the potential to see people who I never saw on Twitch. Either that, or you're using a different name than you used on Twitch. But I definitely recognize your name from comments and stuff, so it's good to see you. Alright, so I need to get down there. I think I need to go right and then drop down, and then head back to the left to get back to the teleporter. Oh no, maybe there's... Yeah, I guess there's no way to get down there from here. Well, that's annoying. See, here it kind of lampshades the whole reference idea by just saying obvious movie quote. Instead of saying something about snakes on a plane or whatever. Which is kind of clever. I guess I have to go through this gauntlet again to get back to the teleporter. Which means making this awesome jump again. Okay, that wasn't too bad. I forgot not to go left. See, that's why you always pay attention to the title of a level. It gives you important information that you don't want to forget. Ah! Oh, why did it have to be snakes? Yeah, that's probably the more obvious movie quote, CPC Gamer. I forgot about Indiana Jones. Of course, I feel like the snakes are on a plane. They are on a geometric, two-dimensional plane. So that might be the more appropriate reference. Oh, crying out loud. But yes, why did it have to be snakes is probably the more obvious one. Ah! Why is this so difficult? I didn't have this much trouble with this jump the first time. I don't think I did, anyway. There we go. I don't even know... Okay, yeah, I need to get back to this area, because this is how I get back to the underground section. Wait, how do I get up there? Damn it. I forget. Oh, I remember that section down there, too. With the four spikes. I need to get down there. So that goes back to the underground section. What's up with all the double jumping in these modern retro games? Double jumping's awesome. It's an enjoyable action. I need to remember that the chat's on the screen, so I don't need to read out every message aloud like I normally do. Okay. I'm doing that a dumb way. By the way, any feedback on the on-screen chat? I mean, I'm sure for those of you watching live, it's totally unnecessary because you can see the chat room yourself, of course. But for people watching the archive, this is really the only way I can embed the chat with the YouTube chat. I can't do my normal captions, as I mentioned, because there's no timestamp in the chat room. So yeah, let me know what you think. For those of you watching live, if you think it's totally obnoxious, then I can just do this. Voila, chat gone. I could also do something like, let's see. I could do something like that, which I don't think that's a better solution, really. Might make the chat easier to read, but I hate wasting all that screen real estate. So yeah, there's really no good way to do it, but this might be the best compromise. Hi, Spider. Alright, I just need to get that last money bag I couldn't get before. Which I know it's around here somewhere. Double jumping. Yeah. Jumping in general isn't as fun in real life as it is in video games. Unless you're like a basketball player, I guess. Then jumping can be pretty fun. as long as it leads to a successful basket. If it doesn't, then it's probably not as much fun. If I miss any money bags on the screen, let me know, because I'm gonna have to go all the way back for them if I do miss them. I don't believe I've missed any yet. Hey, what's up, Skull Crusher? Yeah, that's a good point. Trampolines are pretty cool. I've not done anything on a trampoline since I was a very, very young child. But I do remember it being quite thrilling. I guess I've never been on an actual trampoline, like what you normally think of as a trampoline. I've been on, like, they call it, oh, there's another thing I missed. Oh, wait. Yeah, okay, this is that screen that I said I needed to figure out how to get to. This is how I get there. Awesome. Yeah, they call it like a Jupiter jump, or that's what they called it when I was a kid. Or I guess the generic term for it is bounce house, which is sort of like a trampoline. This pissed me the heck off the first time I did it, because these spikes down here, I thought I would have to jump over them. And I tried really hard to make that jump, and I ended up hitting the ceiling spikes every time. But no, you can just walk across them. No big deal. But yeah, I'd like to jump on an actual trampoline sometime. Seems like fun. Bounce house, not bouncy castle. Is it called a bouncy castle? I've never heard that term for them. Oh, and that takes me back up here. Awesome. I mean, that might be like a regional thing, Jacob Xanth. Around here, the regional term for that when I was a kid was Jupiter jump. Like, that's what it was always called. VXSHU. Well, that seems like a hint. Alright, so there's actually way more than that one money bag that you can grab once you have the wall cling. In England, it's Bouncy Castle. Oh. Well, there you go. Regional dialects. Hey, look, it's a Minecraft reference. Only they said shaft instead of craft. That's pretty cool. That seems like something a kid would say. What's mineshaft? I've only heard of Minecraft. Well, you can call it Bouncy Castle all you want, but that's not how I'd heard it. Alright, so we're at 85%. I'm pretty sure I've gotten every money bag up to the end section. So I'm going to head to the end section and really hope that I'm at 100% by the end of the game. I mean, the ones I bounced in were never shaped like castles. They were just weird cubes. Which is why we all called them bounce cubes. That's what they're called. Bouncy quadrilateral. Oh no, wait, a quadrilateral is a two-dimensional shape. Yggdrasil. Oh yeah. Awesome. I'm glad I thought to go up there. I kind of like the fact that there's no map in this game. Makes the exploration feel more... feels like I'm accomplishing something by figuring out where to go without a map. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like maps in video games. But in this particular game, I think it works okay without a map. The sequel has a map. Super win the game. Bounce house, because it almost rhymes. It sort of does. It's good enough for Emily Dickinson. It's good enough for me. I like how the platforms don't collapse if you cling to the side. I mean, they're still supporting the same amount of weight, whether you cling to the side or whether you stand on top of the platform. So it's nice of them to kind of disregard the laws of physics for you. Okay, I'm just kind of spinning my wheels now. I need to get back to that brick wall that I climbed the outside of. That's the easiest way to get to the end section. You can also get there from the start by doing a series of very tricky wall climbs. I don't think you're necessarily supposed to be able to go that way, but it is an option. How do they support themselves? Well, you see, it's a special video game physics concept called Linovection, which in our reality, that does not exist. More information is available on the internet. Oh yeah, it's this again. Alright, well, let's see if there's anything else I can do this-wise, now that I have the wall cling. Of course, not having a map does make it more tricky if you're going for a 100% run, because you don't have handy icons on the map showing you. Alright, so this is just a secret cat level again. I already got everything here. But at least I get to say hi to the cats again. Hi, cats! Man, cats are awesome. I wish I had a cat. Alright, so I need to find the brick wall. Which, if I was playing any other graphics mode, I wouldn't know it's a brick wall. It would either be a cyan wall or a magenta wall. Everyone knows bricks are red. That's a brick wall, but that's not the one I'm specifically looking for. Oops. That's what I get for glancing at the chat room. What exactly is a fire brick? Do they just call them fire bricks because they're red? Like fire? Or are they fireproof or something? Or maybe they're forged with fire? White bricks are quite common too. Well, I wouldn't call those bricks. They're more blocks. Alright, I think I'm on the right track here. I need to get past this bat again, which hopefully it won't prove as difficult as it did last time. So far it is. Yeah, I think even doing this with 9 lives would be kind of a stretch. Alright, so this is this area. The endless loop. Have I been over here since I got the wall cling? Pretty sure I have, but just to triple check. Speleology. Oh, is this? Okay. Huh. Fungal forest. Pretty sure I've done everything. Well, this is how I got to the area with the wall cling. I don't know if I necessarily came back here once I had the wall cling. Fired bricks are burned in a kiln, which makes them durable. Well, there you go. They're made with fire. They are made out of fire. See, everyone calls them fire bricks without the D. Alright, this is the path to the endgame. I'm on the right track. 90% sure. Actually, I should probably just... I don't think I need to go this way again. Yeah, I was just here pretty recently. So maybe I wasn't on the right path. Dang it. Well, it's all about exploration, right? The fun is the journey, not the destination. Although the destination is pretty good too. I'm close, I think. I remember Yggdrasil being near the end, the path to the end. I mean, I'm in the red brick area, which seems right. But I don't think it's the right red brick area. I'm so confused. Hey, remember that power up? Good times. I am level. Oh yeah, that game looked pretty cool. That is on my list of stuff to check out. I mean, on one level, it's kind of good. Here we go. This is the right way. I am 100% sure. Yes! Snake, it's a snake. On one level, it's kind of good that I don't really know where I'm going. Because I can explore a lot of screens a second time and make sure I didn't miss anything. This is the red brick area. Yes! I'm totally on the right path. Cats don't know the magic word. Huh. Well, that'll just take me back close to the beginning of the game. I guess that's where I need to go now that I have the wall clean. Yeah, up here. Yes, this is correct. Okay. Really hope I didn't miss anything. Exit strategy. So, real quick, I'm going to... I said you can get to that area from the beginning, but it's tricky. Oh, yeah. Wow, I didn't even see that money bag. It blended in with the leaves so perfectly. You can do that to get up there. Yeah, you can cling off this tiny little outcropping. Oh, I did it perfectly the first time, and now I want to screw it up. Naturally. It's a tricky jump, so I'm just going to bounce out and then load my save. Because last time I saved is already up here. But yes, if you don't want to go the long way around, you can get up there the way I just showed off and then wasn't able to do again. Hardcore Prawn. I get it. It's like that TV show, Hardcore Pawn. Color scheme reminds you of Keen. Yeah, this game does, it kind of reminds me of Commander Keen, just in general. Controls are much more smooth than Commander Keen, though. Alright, so I need to get that money bag up there. How do I get that? Well, I guess I have to go left and then go around somehow. Alright, I remember actually needing to watch the pattern pretty carefully. So after the one on the bottom right fires, and then after that one. There we go. Nope, not fast enough. There we go. Piece of cake. Doriath. I forgot the money in the tree. Which money in the tree do you mean? Is it the one I already got? Is it the one from a little bit ago? Oh, wait. Oh, that's right. It didn't save when I picked it up. Okay. Thank you, CPC Gamer. I would have felt really bad if I forgot about that. Thank you. What's down here? Alright, I'm gonna have to go around to get that one as well. Oh yeah, this part sucks. I spent a lot of time. Because it respawns you. When it respawns you, you're already falling. There's a much trickier version of this area in extra spicy mode, which is what caused me the most consternation while playing this game. Alright, 90%. I feel like that's pretty good. I feel like I'm on track for 100% run. Spooky. Do I know the magic symbol? I think I do. Do I know the magic word? Pretty sure I do. Ah, crap. Maybe I'm not on track for 100%. I need to go back and get that money bag on the hardcore prawn area that I missed. Thank you, CPC Gamer. By the way, YouTube gave me two options for my live stream. There was a low latency option for interacting better with the chat, and then there was a... I forget what the other option was called, but it implied that the low latency option might cause people video issues. So let me know if any of you are having buffering or anything. It seems like the low latency thing is working pretty well. If you follow my main Twitter account at Matt Brabin, MattBrabbin, I posted some tweets while I was playing this game, and I posted a GIF of the area I'm talking about in extra spicy mode. It caused me a lot of grief. Do you want to go back and find that? Man, I need to get back. I need to get back to the prawn area. Alright, I think I know what I need to do. Yeah, Galen, I think the way I get back, I need to go this way first. This is a really creepy looking screen. Like, I don't know what all this stuff is. Like, random monster claws sticking out of the wall. So this is the point of no return. If you head down, if you head left, you get to safety. And that's actually how I get that money back. Good. Alright. I don't think this is going to be 100% run. But I forget how many percentage points this area of the game is worth. So if you go this way, you lose the game. Which I'm going to... I'm pretty sure if I go in there, my save will still exist. I just want to show this off. Failure is a nth chance. So I can pick up that money bag. Then if I get this item, I lose the game. But will my save still exist? All right, well, let's see. All right, so it's still at 92%. So obviously, my save has to still exist if I'm able to 100% the game. Right? 94%. Oh, I think my save will still exist, but I won't have any of the items or anything. And do I have to do this to 100% the game? That's kind of lame. I think I do. Alright, well, that's the consolation prize, and it starts me back here at 94%. I do not have my double jump or the items. So let's quit back and see if my save still exists. Nope, it overwrote my save. Okay, well, we just have to do everything again. Should be pretty easy. I mean, I just spent an hour and a half doing it, right? But I know where I'm going now, which is the important part. Mostly. I kind of forgot that you have to do this if you want 100%. That's kind of a bummer. Oh well, gives me more time to hang out with y'all. Right, so first thing I have to do is fight the Hollow King, get the Red Ghost blocks. Which is not this way. I'm pretty sure on extra spicy mode, you only have to play it once to 100% it. I'm pretty sure anyway. Oh, maybe this is the right way. What do I know? Cannot get up there yet. Oh yeah, I never got that. Okay, well, now I know I need to come back for that. I remember that money bag in particular when I played the game the first time. I totally forgot about that one, and I spent forever trying to figure out where it was. So now I know. Oh. Yeah, that's right. I guess the red block is first. I guess technically the crab is the first boss. Not the Hollow King. Or maybe you can do those in any order. I never got that one either. Dang. I wasn't as close to 100% as I thought. I guess that's why they make you do everything a second time, so you can remember all this shit. And by they, I mean the one guy who made this game. Oh, can't do that yet because I don't have the blue blocks. Okay. Maybe I underestimated how long it was going to take me to finish this game again. Because I had 6 hours of playtime after I 100% of both modes last time. So about 3 hours apiece for each mode. And I thought, oh well, now that I know what I'm doing, I can just blow past that. Like an hour for each mode. I guess that's not the case. Definitely doesn't help that my memory is terrible. I've probably done so much unnecessary backtracking. There's an achievement for beating this game in 10 minutes. Which is another one of those super hard challenges that I'll probably never be able to do. Looking for the Hollow King. I need to get back to the mineshaft, Minecraft area. I'm sure if I remembered exactly which way to do everything, I'd be able to beat this game in maybe not 10 minutes, but it wouldn't take me another hour and a half. Here we go. This seems closer to... No? Well, maybe not. Well, this is slightly frustrating. Maybe going for a 100% run on a stream was kind of silly. But, oh well, I'm committed now. Can't change my mind this late in the game, especially now that my save is gone. Or my save is still here, but my power-ups are gone. I think I need to get over to the left. But I tried going that way and I hit a dead end, if I remember correctly. Okay, this is the quarry hub. This is the grand vault. I need to go down, I think. Hit stop. Alright, snakes on a plane. Don't be hasty. Okay, I need the blue blocks to do that, so... Need the blue blocks to do that. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm sure I'm overthinking this. I'm sure there's just an obvious path I haven't taken yet. Here we go. This looks more correct. Foot of the throne, yes. The Hollow King, thank you. Blue blocks. Yes. Can't get back up there. P. Well, that's not nearly enough P. You tell YouTube to straighten up and fly right. Hopefully that's not something using more of my internet connection. I don't think I have anything turned on that would use my internet connection. Unless Windows is silently updating in the background or something, which it shouldn't be. Ha! Take that jump. Oh yeah. See? See what I said about my memory? It is not good. 8-bit resolution, I know. I mean, this is an 8-bit style game, so I suppose that would be appropriate, but it takes some liberties with resolution and whatnot. I like that recent trend, like Shovel Knight did that, where you have a game that emulates old style games pretty well, but it also takes modern things like widescreen into consideration, and you know, being able to do things that, I mean, obviously, Shovel Knight is patterned after old NES games, but it does a ton of stuff that NES wouldn't be able to do. But it still feels like an NES game, despite those modern considerations. I really hate this screen. I really hate that bat. Thank you. Oh yeah! I need to play the Shovel Knight DLC. I totally forgot about that. The Plague Knight campaign came out while I didn't have a computer. And I heard people talk about that on podcasts and stuff. And I was like, man, I wish I had a computer so I can play the Plague Knight campaign. And now that I have a computer, I totally forgot. I think I get it for free. I think it's a free download for people who have Shovel Knight already. Oh yeah, it's another good example, Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. Alright, so I need to go this way to get the next power-up, right? This is where the spring boots are. Man, I'm really looking forward to playing more Shovel Knight. I really like that game. From what I understand, the new campaign is pretty similar to the old game. You just play as Plague Knight, and he controls completely differently than Shovel Knight does. Like, I don't know how many changes they made to the actual game, if any. But I'm looking forward to seeing what it's all about. That might be stream material. Playing through that blind. Alright, we're already 3/4 of the way there, technically. Another game I should stream some more, Super Amazing Wagon Adventure. I think I streamed that once, or maybe twice. That's a pretty fun game. See, if I actually remembered where I was going, it would have only taken me a few minutes to get to the Spring Heel Boots. I mean, if you're not going to collect all the money, you can get through this game extremely quickly. Again, if you know where you're going. Ha! I remembered you, money back. So I need to go down to the prawn area and get that other money bag I couldn't get before. Not the hardcore prawn area, the other area with the prawn. Which I can't get going this way because I can't make that jump. Awesome. Yeah, there are a bunch of games that came out while my computer was dead that I still want to try out. I want to play that game Undertale, which is like a retro-style Earthbound-inspired RPG. That game sounds really cool. Oh, that just takes me back here. Awesome. And the PC port of Grandia 2 came out. Well, it already had a PC port, but they modernized it and made it work on modern computers. I guess they didn't modernize it. Maybe it runs in a higher resolution, but it's available on Steam. And I really like Grandia 2. I never finished that game. I'd like to play through that game again. One of those games you want to see but not play. Well, that might be a game I would LP. Or stream. I don't play a game, or I don't play many games with a lot of text for streams or LPs, because that's another thing I'm anxious about. Like, when I first started LPing, I was posting on somethingawful.com. I mean, that's where the whole Let's Play hobby kind of got started. And there were a lot of people there who were kind of jerks about certain things. And one thing that I heard a lot of complaints about was reading text aloud. Like, people really didn't like it when people did that, and I got some shit for it. So now I'm kind of hesitant to play games with a lot of text, because I feel like whether I read it aloud or read it silently, either way there are going to be people who hate it, so kind of a no-lose situation. That's another one of those things I just need to kind of let go and just kind of play stuff to have fun and not trying to make people happy. Deliberately slow. Well, what do you mean, Galen? Are they playing that game deliberately slow, or is that just their style? I haven't watched a ton of Game Grumps stuff. I watched one video a friend linked me to when they were playing Super Mario 64. And I enjoyed it. I'm not really interested in Mario 64 though, so it's not the kind of thing I would want a full playthrough of. I didn't know Guardian Heroes came out on Steam. That's pretty cool. Alright, I need to... I have all my items, so I could go beat the game. I need to get that money bag that was in that prawn area that I couldn't get before. As far as I know, that's the only money bag I'm missing, other than the end game. I don't think I need to go this way. This just leads back to the cat area. Yeah, I never played many Saturn games, Vice Commando. I had one friend, well, it was more like a friend of a friend, who had a Saturn. But I never really got to do anything on it, which is a shame. It sounds like the Saturn has some pretty cool games. Of course, that whole generation of consoles, I wasn't super into. Like, I didn't have a PlayStation until the PlayStation 2 was already out, I don't think. Or maybe it was close to the end of the PS1's life cycle. Oh, 15 minutes at a time, okay. I mean, I can definitely see why people would be into that style. I've definitely gravitated more towards longer videos in recent years, though. I like putting videos, like long videos on, or streams on, in the background while I do other stuff, and like for example, I've been playing Fire Emblem on the 3DS, on and off, and in between the story missions there are kind of less important fights, just kind of, not random battles, since you're not obligated to do them, but just not story missions. So I'll watch an LP or a stream or something on my TV while I sit on the couch and play Fire Emblem. You know, I never got whatever's down here. I just realized that. Now that I have my gloves, I can slide down that wall. Okay, this is a whole area of the game that I missed. There's just one money back here. Hey, what's up, Alex? Binge is the only way to go, yeah. Or I'll put videos on my Android device and take them with me to work, and I will watch them when it's slow, and when work comes in, I'll just keep listening to it. And it works out pretty well. If something happens on the screen that sounds important, but I'm not paying attention, I'll just rewind it a little bit. Alright, so looking for the prawn area. I know it's relatively close to the beginning of the game. I kinda wish there was just a teleport to beginning button or something. That would make this a bit easier. Fire Emblem is really good, by the way. Like, when I first played that game, I don't think I really got it. Because it was pretty different from Shining Force, which was my main exposure to that kind of tactical, turn-based battle system. But, I gave Fire Emblem another shot, and I'm really enjoying it the second time around. Of course, I'm playing on normal mode and casual, so my party members don't die permanently if they die. So, some might say that I'm not really playing the game the way it's meant to be played, but I don't care. I'm having fun. Yep, I feel exactly the same way, Galen. Of course, I have kind of a lot of time to kill. Like, at work, I can listen to podcasts and listen to videos and whatever I want pretty much all day. I know a lot of people don't really have that kind of time. So, I can see why the 15-minute video format is popular among some people. Because, you know, if someone can't watch videos or listen to videos all day, then they might want to come home and just watch a few, you know, short chunks to kind of relax after work. So, it has its place. Sometimes this is the easiest thing in the world for me to do. I should say, you definitely shouldn't go left or down. Because you really don't have a reason to go down here. It's not as big of a setback as if you go left. Oh boy, it's my favorite screen. I think I've said this before, but any video game that has bats, the common factor between those games is that the bats are always the most annoying enemy in the game. I've rarely found a game that breaks that rule. The bats in Mega Man 2 are fine. There's nothing wrong with those bats. But I think Mega Man 2 is the exception that proves the rule. Find me another game where the bats aren't the most annoying thing in it. Well, I guess Daggerfall. But, I mean, RPG bats are just kind of fodder enemies. As far as action games go, as far as platformers specifically, bats are always the worst thing. I guess Castlevania, the bats are bad, but they're not as bad as, like, the Medusa heads. But other than those 10 exceptions I just mentioned, it's a hard and fast rule. Wizards and Warriors. Are the bats good or bad in that game? Original Zelda had easy bats. Okay, Vice Commando. But Zelda's not a platformer. This rule is only for platformers. Keep proving me wrong and I'll keep moving the goalposts. Thank God. Right. That leads back to the cave. I don't need to go back there. In Wizards and Warriors, everything is just as annoying. Well, if it's equally annoying, then that still counts, I think. Oh, hi. Wow, I didn't even see that. I've been on the screen so many times, I didn't even know there was a money back there. I need to get back to the beginning, because I think if I went to the beginning, I'd be able to figure out how to get to the money bag I'm thinking of from there, from that place. This is pretty close to the beginning, isn't it? Maybe not. See, I've been here. Because I marveled at how I haven't been here before. Have I been to the other side of that section, though? With all the red platforms? I don't remember. I probably should have played this game again on my own before I tried to stream it. Man, no way to get across that, even with all the power-ups. Yeah, there's no reason for me to go that way. Emergent gameplay? So what exactly is emerging? I'll tell you what's emerging. Frustration. Frustration is emerging from my brain. Any afterbirth stuff planned? Well, that's a really bad sentence out of context, Alex Verrill. Boy, no, I'm not planning to do anything with any afterbirth. God, I hate The Binding of Isaac sometimes. I hate it for the sentences that it makes me say. I don't know. I'm sure I'll check out any Binding of Isaac DLC that comes out. I don't know if I will necessarily stream it. I mean, I've still barely scratched the surface of Rebirth, so I don't really need any more DLC at the moment. But I'm sure I'll pick it up. I remember when Edmund McMillan said that Wrath of the Lamb was going to be the last Binding of Isaac thing that ever came out. Boy, that sure didn't happen. Of course, he also said that Super Meat Boy would never, ever, ever, in a million years, ever come out on PlayStation. And I think it just came out on PlayStation pretty recently. So, Edmund McMillan, not necessarily the most trustworthy of people. That's a joke. I'm not saying he's really not trustworthy. I'm just saying you can't always plan for the future. I forget what happens if I go right from here. I think it's just a money bag that I already picked up and there's nothing else that way, but I want to make sure. Hey, what's up, Rage of Leo? Oh, is Meat Boy only coming out on the Vita? I thought it was coming out on, like, PS3 and PS4 as well. Oh, okay, it just wraps around. Awesome. Even better. It's my second favorite area of this game. I read the screen. Aw, man! My two favorite areas of the game, back to back. But this time I did it, no problem. And now I'm back here again. I really don't know how to get to the place I'm trying to get to. Like, I am super lost. Oh, free on Vita for PS Plus. Man, hearing about PS Plus kind of makes me wish I had a PlayStation. Because the amount of free stuff you get for, like, well, I mean, it's not free. You're paying, like, what, $60 a year for it? Makes me jealous. That's a lot of cool free stuff. I probably would have played Rocket League if I had a PlayStation. Or is that one PS4 only? Forget if it's... That's the only confusing thing about the PS Plus, is what stuff comes out where. But if it was free, I definitely would have checked Rocket League out. I heard a lot of people have a lot of fun with that game. That was a cool noise. Have I left Twitch? Well, I don't know. This whole streaming on YouTube thing is kind of an experiment. I mean, both Twitch and YouTube both have their pluses and minuses. On Twitch, I have a chat log that I can use to do chaptions instead of having the chat on screen like I have it now. But on the downside, a lot of people have issues with Twitch chat. A lot of people have issues watching videos on Twitch. It's just not as reliable as it could be. So far, YouTube seems pretty reliable. I haven't heard of people having many issues with it since they introduced the whole YouTube gaming thing. And also, there's no ads, which is a pretty good plus in my book. I don't want people to watch my stuff only to be exposed to ads. And when I stream on YouTube, I don't have to worry about exporting it or anything. Okay, this is the beginning. I said if I get back to the beginning, I can find that prawn thing. Let's see if that's true. Because I think if I get the prawn thing, I'm done. I can just go to the end and win the game. I just need to remember where the prawn thing is. Now, if I go down, that takes me back to the branching path. Where you can go left or right. Won't get notifications anymore when the streams are up. Well, what kind of notifications were you getting on Twitch, Vice Commanda? Or are you on some kind of like mobile device or something? Where notifications are an issue, but they're not an issue on YouTube. That's... oh my god. This is so much freaking effort just for one money bag. Phone. Okay, cool. Well, someone... I streamed Trackmania on Twitch the other day, and one of the viewers there said that he has the opposite problem. Well, not the opposite problem, but like... he was saying that on mobile, he couldn't, like, watch and chat at the same time. I need to... Oh. Yeah, I forget what his actual complaint was, but he was saying that on YouTube, it didn't work as well on mobile devices. So, you know, that's a whole other factor that you have to take into consideration when deciding whether you stream on Twitch or YouTube, is how people with a mobile experience are going to be affected. So it's a big balancing act, you know? I mean, I'm thinking I like YouTube better overall, just because I've had so many issues with Twitch over the years. No, that's not the way I need to go either. Fudge! Is it this way? Maybe it's this way. Please let it be this way. Yes! This is it! This is the prawn screen! Ha! Hallelujah! I just had to go past the jellyfish. Oh my god, okay, I'm at 98%, so I'm pretty sure when I go to the end, I'm going to have one money bag is 1%. Oh wait, I need to go this way again anyway. Maybe there's no money bag at the end, and you just get the last percentage point for winning the game. Oh, there's nothing over here. Yes, the Metroids. The damn Metroids were my problem the whole time. All right, now I just have to figure out how to get back to where I was before. Which means I need to go up here. Yes, excellent. Okay. I really hope there's nothing I'm missing. If I get to the end again and I don't have 100%, I will be very sad. This is a totally arbitrary thing that doesn't really make any difference to anything in the grand scheme of things. It's just a number. But dang it, I want that number. I was trying to get to the checkpoint before I died. Wait, is there anything down here? There was, but I already got it, I'm pretty sure. Is there anything down here? There was, but I already got it. Alright, there better be a money bag at the end of this game. Because if there's not, I'm going to end with 99%. I think if you choose the win the game path, you still keep all of your power-ups though. So it would be relatively easy for me to jump back in and try to start looking for that last money bag. Alright, I already lost, so no need to go that way. Let's go this way. Alright, so, remember the two clues we found over the course of this game. The VXSHU and the weird 3 symbol. Well, that means you need to replace the letters with the letter, 3 letters behind it. So, I already know what this is. So, this is the one puzzle in this game. Old Atari games. Yeah, I mean, the Atari, the 5200, I think, would have been the closest comparison. SU. Wait, I am forgetting something very important. Oh, maybe I'm not. Well, if you jump in here, it takes you back here. So if you can't figure out the puzzle, then you can go through the lose door and restart the whole thing. But I know what the solution to the puzzle is. Unfortunately, there's no money back here, so I think I'm going to end this with 99%. The Atari 5200 was the computer, right? I think that's the one I'm thinking of. SUPE. R. So now that I spelled out super, now that I solved the puzzle, you come in here, you jump through there, you go through the wind door, and 99%. I'm missing 0.88. percent, or no, 0.78% of the treasure, but I still have my power, so time to figure out where this last dang treasure bag is. Thank you, CPC Gamer. Thank you for the encouragement. I'm thinking there's something I missed in that endlessly looping area with the, I guess it was more prawns. I don't think I... Oops. I don't think I explored that area as thoroughly as I could have. Now I just have to figure out how to get back there. Fun times. Of course, that might be the wrong track completely, so who knows? Everyone, keep your eyes peeled. If you see a money bag, let me know. Sometimes they can blend in with the background. Like that one on the tree that I nearly missed, except I happened to stumble into it. Favorite screen number one and favorite screen number two coming up. Solstice on the NES. Wow. I never played Solstice, but that sounds like a pretty frustrating experience. It also sounds very familiar. Oh man, do I want to go back through the cave system again? I'm pretty sure I got everything there, but I have no idea where the last money bag actually is. Like, I suspect that it's in that other prawn area, but I'm not 100% sure. So I kind of have to just explore everything again. Already been at this for 2.25 hours. That's nuts. Technically, I am going to finish this game, or I'm on track to finish the game in less time than it took me the first time, so I'm doing slightly better. Oh, I would have had to go this way to get the spring boots again. Anyway. Wait, have I been up here? Yeah, there's nothing up here. Or is there? Wow. That would be the most frustrating video game ever. A game that it's impossible to 100%. I think my anal retentiveness would also kick in a game like Castlevania Symphony of the Night, where you can get more than 100%. Like, I think that would bother me if I was playing SOTN and I didn't know about that. Like, if I'm at 100%, I think, wow, awesome, I 100%ed this game. And then, if I did something that would push me over 100%, my thought would be, well, how do I know what the top is? If it's not 100, then what is it? Is it 200? How much stuff do I have to do? So that would really frustrate me as well. Unless, I mean, I could look it up. I know it's like 100 and... I think it's like around 170 or 180% is the highest percent you can get in Symphony of the Night. But man, if you didn't know that, that would be maddening. I mean, I try not to care too much about that stuff. But when it's like a core element of the game, it's kind of hard not to. Oh, Donkey Kong Country was also more than 100%. That sucks. Alright, I'm not missing anything here. I'm pretty sure I'm not. I hope I'm not. My god. I mean, I could never find this last treasure. I could be here all night. Oh, Symphony of the Night is 200.6. Wow. What a weird, imprecise number. Like, even that is kind of making me twitch. Just the fact that 0.6% exists. I should get another drink of water. Okay. If I was a treasure, where would I be? You have to think like a treasure. It's the only way you can find it. Right, I got that one. That's the one that eluded me for the longest time. Oh, hey, what's up, Pinfeldorf? Thanks for hanging out. Good to see you. ...218% if you abuse wall glitches. Wow. Okay. Oh, it's fish. It's not prawns. This is the other screen that I was thinking of. That I didn't explore very thoroughly. Because this just takes you... Okay, I know this is just gonna wrap around. But I just have to make sure. Okay, thank you. Thank you for appeasing my brain. Okay, have I been left here? Yes, that takes you out there. This is some non-Euclidean geometry going on here. Well, speaking of non-Euclidean geometry, I haven't had a chance to show off my new Be Right Back screen, so this is what I have set up. I think it's kind of cool. I found this animated GIF on the internet. It's quite mesmerizing. A pipe organ. Yeah, that's pretty appropriate. Okay, anyway. I don't know. I thought of non-Euclidean geometry and I wanted to show that off. That sounds like a pretty good soundtrack for Symphony of the Night. I don't technically have to go on this platform now that I have the wall clay and stuff, but it might be easier, because you can drop off here and kind of take shelter from those bullets. Okay, so that leads you here. Is there any other... Alright! That's why I didn't... Ugh. God, I have to... Silence. I was not done exploring that area, game. It's pretty rude of you to just shunt me into this completely other area. Now I have to figure out how to get back there again. I remember I had to go left, and there were some jellyfish there. Or some Metroids there. I don't remember the context. No, take your time. You have all the time in the world. Okay, going that way won't give me anything, I don't think. Was it in the cave area? I'll be right back. Sorry about that. The 20th anniversary of Jurassic Park. See, that didn't really make me feel that old, because Jurassic Park feels like forever ago to me. Like, I've only seen it once. And it was when I was a really tiny child. So, honestly, it feels like 20 years since Jurassic Park. I don't know. I mean, I'm 30. I just turned 30 in June. I don't really feel that old. Which I guess is good. A lot of people my age are saying that they're starting to feel old. Now that they're... What? You have got to be kidding me. There's a money bag there. I forgot to change my scene. Sorry about that. Wow. Okay, so here's what happened. I teleported back into the cave area. This is going to be much less dramatic now that you won't be able to see what happened. So here I am, back in the underground area. I went through that teleporter, or not that teleporter, I went through a similar teleporter. I'm back here now. Oh, here, I was going along, minding my own business. I was just going the normal way, double-checking the underground area. I can't jump that way. No, you didn't miss it. I quit back to the menu, and I was going to... I did it again. Because here I was, going along, minding my own business, and I landed there. Let me do that one more time, just to show off the insanity of this. It's a treasure, sitting over there, the exact color of the surrounding rock. It looks, I mean, it barely looks like there's even anything there. But that's the last treasure. I am so angry right now, you guys. I'm controlling my anger through the power of self-hypnosis, but trust me, inside, I am just seething with rage. And I'm especially mad that I didn't get that moment on video, but I forgot to switch back to the scene. Alright, so now all I have to do is finish the game one last time to show off the 100% screen. Which should be pretty simple now that I've done it so many times. Famous last words. I'm going this way under the theory that it's a faster way to circle back around to the way I need to go. Yes, exactly, Vice Commander. The good ending. I mean, I got the bad ending, I got the okay ending, and now I need to get the good ending. So let's see, if I jump this way... and then circle... this way. There we go. It's a little shortcut for you. Oh no, I'm not a civilization person, Pinfeldorf. I tried the game once, and it was a little overwhelming for me. I thought it was cool. I could see myself potentially getting into it, but... it didn't quite get its hooks into me, just because I really didn't know what I was doing. I mean, I was following along with the tutorial and stuff. But it was still... I don't play mini games like that, so it was still a little overwhelming. Nope. I would like to play more strategy games, though. I think the next big game I'm going to stream is going to be Shadowrun Returns. Because I really like that game. I don't do nearly enough, like, RPGs on my stream. And I would like to show that game off. And also a sequel, Dragonfall, which I haven't played yet. But I would like to. On stream. And that's a very strategy-heavy game as well. It's a different kind of strategy, of course, but it's a kind of strategy that I really enjoy. Yeah, Shadowrun Returns is great, Pinfeldorf. Highly recommend going back to it. And I hear that Dragonfall is even better. Combat feels off, really? I really enjoyed it. Then again, maybe it's because I'm not a big strategy guy, and I guess it's kind of dumbed down. It's like, I mean, not dumbed down, that's a bad way to phrase it, but it's less strategy-heavy XCOM, I'd say, is an okay way of describing it. When... ...100%. Feels pretty good. And it only took me 2 hours and 22 minutes. Oh, might as well start a new game. Nah, I'm not gonna do this right now. I'll show off the beginning, and I will show off cat mode. But I'll save extra spicy mode for another day. Thank you, CPC Gamer. I appreciate your congratulation. So this is cat mode. Control's pretty much the same, except... well, this isn't a control thing, but 6 lives remaining, 5 lives, 4 lives, 3 lives, 2 lives. And game over. You lose all lives, starts you back here, no power-ups. And extra spicy mode is a jerk. There are a lot of precise jumps you have to make. There are a lot of trial and error stuff. Kind of Kaizo Mario style. I'm not actually going to play as a cat when I do the stream. But I just wanted to show off what the cat looks like. Because it's kind of cute. Alright, so that'll do it for You Have to Win the Game for today. Thanks to everyone who came to hang out. I'd say the YouTube experiment was pretty successful. Everyone let me know how you feel about me doing this on YouTube, how you feel about having the chat room up there. If you have any suggestions, I'd love to hear them. And I will do a stream again pretty soon. It was cool getting to hang out. Cool to see people I haven't seen in a while. Hope you're all doing well. I'll see you soon. Goodbye.